Lesson 17, dragging and dropping into mind map from Word documents, web pages, and plain text. People often create mind maps using information copied from Word documents, web pages, or plain text. Let's learn how to do this in Concept Draw Mind Map. As an example, let's create a mind map from this example of a Microsoft Word document named Company Newsletter Elements. Create a new mind map in Concept Draw Mind Map. To set the title of your new mind map, switch to the Word document, select the document title, and then copy it to the clipboard. Switch back to the mind map and paste the copied text into the main idea topic by clicking on the paste icon in the menu or by using the shortcut Ctrl+V. Now you have the title topic of your mind map. Switch back to the Word document. Select all headlines of the sections in the document by clicking on your mouse and holding down the Ctrl key. Copy the selection to the clipboard. Switch back to the mind map. Paste the copied headlines into the mind map by clicking on the paste icon in the menu or by using the shortcut Ctrl+V. Now let's insert some text from paragraphs in the Word document into the mind map as callouts attached to main topics of the corresponding headlines. Select the text of the first paragraph using your mouse and click on the copy icon. In the mind map, select the corresponding main topic and click on the callout icon. Then click on the paste icon. In the same way, create callouts with comments for the other main topics. Now let's insert a few paragraphs from one section of the Word document into the mind map as subtopics to the corresponding main topic. Select all paragraphs in one section of the Word document by clicking on your mouse and holding down the Ctrl key. In the mind map, select the corresponding main topic and click on the paste icon. Each copied paragraph appears as a separate subtopic of the main topic. In the same way, add subtopics of text from section paragraphs to a few main topics. Once your mind map is ready, you can use it in a variety of ways, for example, showing it as a presentation. You can learn more about this in Lesson 18. Lesson 18, Presentation Exchange Solution, Importing PowerPoint Presentations. The Presentation Exchange Solution from Concept Draw Solution Park adds the ability to Concept Draw Mind Map to export to Microsoft PowerPoint, as well as to import from it. We learned how to export from Concept Draw Mind Map in Lesson 3. Now let's learn how to import from Microsoft PowerPoint to Concept Draw Mind Map. We will import a sample PowerPoint presentation to Concept Draw Mind Map. Click on the Input tab. Select the Business Presentation Exchange Solution in the Business Productivity area located in the left window column. Select the Microsoft PowerPoint icon in the middle window column and then double-click on it. In the open window, select the source PowerPoint file and click on the Open button. You will see a mind map created from the imported PowerPoint presentation. We have just learned how to import PowerPoint files into Concept Draw Mind Map. This feature is very useful for restructuring PowerPoint presentations. All you have to do is import them into Mind Map for the fast restructuring of slides, and then export them back as PowerPoint presentations. You can learn more about the Presentation Exchange Solution by visiting Solution Park at conceptdraw.com. Lesson 19, the four viewing modes, full screen, map only, outline only, map and outline. utilizing one-click navigation. Conceptual Mind Map provides four viewing modes and a one-click navigation tool for viewing and editing large mind maps. Let's learn about these modes and their benefits. Map Only mode is a default mode which you see when you start Conceptual Mind Map. To see the different viewing modes, click on the View tab. Full screen mode is convenient when you need to overview, analyze, or present the mind map, especially larger ones. To switch to the full screen mode, click on the full screen icon or use the Shift F5 shortcut. Outline only and map and outline modes are useful for viewing and editing very large mind maps which do not fit into the window with a readable zoom when in map only mode. Viewing and editing a large mind map as an outline is especially handy when using the expand and collapse feature. Now let's learn about the one-click navigation tool for the temporary or permanent zooming in and centering of a selected topic or a group of topics in the selected rectangular area of the screen. This can help you view and edit parts of a large map that can be hard to read when fit to window. First, let's see how to temporarily zoom in and center a selected topic. Click on the topic and hold the mouse button. After 1 second, the selected topic will be zoomed in and centered on the screen. When you release the mouse button, the map will return to its original zoom and focus. Second, let's learn how to permanently zoom in and center a selected topic. Do the same as in the previous step, but press the space bar before you release the mouse button. The map will stay zoomed in and with the selected topic in the center of the screen. Third, let's learn how to temporarily zoom in and center a group of topics in the selected rectangular area of the screen. Move the mouse to any virtual corner of the rectangular area with the topics group you wish to zoom in and center. Press and hold the mouse button while you move the cursor to the diagonal corner of the rectangular area which appears on the screen. Continue holding the mouse button. After 1 second, all the topics within the selected rectangular area will be zoomed in and centered on the screen. When you release the mouse button, the map will return to its original zoom and focus. Finally, let's learn how to permanently zoom in and center a group of topics in the selected rectangular area of the screen. Do the same as in the previous step, but press the space bar before you release the mouse button. The map will stay zoomed in and with the selected group of topics in the center of the screen. Now you have learned how to use the various Conceptual mind map viewing modes and one-click navigation, which is helpful when working with large mind maps. There's also the possibility to set full screen mode as a default when opening a mind map. You can learn more about this in Lesson 20. Lesson 20, Application Settings, Opening in Full Screen Mode, Default Theme. In this lesson, we will learn how to set up application options, including opening in full screen mode and changing the default map theme. Let's learn how to set up application options. Click on the File tab and then click on the Mind Map Options button. The Options window will appear. In the left part of this window, you will see a menu with four tabs: General, View, Spelling, and Format. The General tab is selected, so in the right part of the window, you will see four sections. The upper section allows you to manage startup settings. The second section allows you to set up new documents and provides two options: Empty Map, which is the default, and From Template. Under the last option, there is an edit box for entering a path to the template file and the folder icon for opening the Select File window. The third section contains an edit box for typing in your nickname and then a checkbox for usage nickname for notes. The bottom section contains a checkbox to switch the auto recover feature on and off, and a selection box for setting the time interval in minutes for auto recover. Now select the View tab in the left part of the Options window. In the right part of the window, you see three sections. The upper section allows you to set up Map Only mode, Outline Only mode, or Map and Outline mode as a default view mode. You can also set up Full Screen mode as a default view mode by ticking the checkbox. In the middle section of the right window, you can set up a default quick symbol set and color scheme. In the bottom section of the right window part, you can set up the application language. The default is set to English. Select the Spelling tab in the left part of the Options window. In the right part of the window, you see a list of dictionaries for spelling with checkboxes and a checkbox for check spelling as you type. At the bottom, you will see the option Edit Custom Dictionary, which when open, you can add, change, or delete words. Select the Format tab in the left part of the Options window. In the right part of the window, you see two sections. In the upper section, you can set up the format of text in topic notes. There is font type, font size and color, and also text alignment and background color. In the lower section, you can set up the default map theme via the selection box. Once you make all application settings, apply it by clicking on OK or click the Cancel button if you do not wish to save the changes. Now you have learned how to set up ConceptDraw Mind Map so that it is a more convenient workspace, making it easier to work in full screen mode and to change the appearance of your mind maps by setting a default theme. There is also the possibility to edit your mind map appearance or even create your own themes. You can learn more about this in Lesson 21. Lesson 21, Advanced Formatting, Formatting Topics, Tails, Relations, Callouts, and Mind Maps, Creating a Custom Theme. In this lesson, we will learn the advanced formatting features of ConceptDraw Mind Map and how to create a custom map theme. To format topics, select the topics you wish to format and click on the Format tab. To set the topic style, use Shape, Fill, and Topic Line tools. To change the font of a topic, click on Font. To set topic clip art alignment, margins, and spacing, go to the Layout section. If you plan to use the same formats in your custom theme, use the Apply to Current Level tool. To format topic tails, use the tail line tail and anchor tools. If you plan to use the same topic tail format in your custom theme, use the Apply to Current Level tool. To format the relations, select the relation or relations you wish to format and click on the Format tab. To change the relation's type, use the tools from the Type section. To change the relation style, use tools from the Style section, Line and Endpoints. To change ordering, use tools from the Ordering section. If you plan to use the same relations formatting in your custom theme, use the Apply to All tool. To format callouts, select the callout or callouts you wish to format and click on the Format tab. To set callout style, use the Shape, Fill, and Line tools. To format callout fonts, click on Font. To set callout clip art alignment, margins, and spacing, go to the Layouts tab. If you plan to use the same callout formats in your custom theme, use the Apply to All tool. To format an entire mind map, click on the Layout tab. To set up the arrangement of topics, use the arrangement tools Radial, Right, Left, Top, or Bottom. To style the map, select a theme in the Map Theme Gallery. To set background color, use the Background tool. To automatically numerate topics, use the Auto-Numeration tool. To change topic order, use the Order tool. To sort topics, use the Sort Topics tool. To create a custom theme, click on the little arrow in the right bottom corner of the Map Theme section. In the Open Map Theme window, you can set formatting for the map's focus, selection, overlap, inner highlight, selection rounded rectangle, and expand and collapse pictures. Now you can save your custom theme. Click on the down arrow in the right bottom corner of the Map Theme Gallery. From the pull-down menu, click on Save Theme. In the Save As window, set the path and file name for your theme and click on Save. To open a custom map theme, use Open Theme, which is located just above Save Theme. Using the advanced formatting options for the generation of custom themes, you can create unique and creative mind maps with your own personal or corporate style. Lesson 22, Hotkey Review. Keyboard shortcuts are powerful tools for advanced users. Shortcuts help you work with ConceptDraw Mind Map faster and more conveniently. Let's review the ConceptDraw Mind Map shortcuts. To see the keyboard shortcuts table in PDF format, click on the Help icon, which is designated by the question mark symbol, and select Keyboard Shortcuts in the pull-down menu. You see the PDF document Keyboard Shortcuts. We will review the shortcuts from this document and also describe in ConceptDraw Mind Map the interface elements that are duplicated by using the different shortcuts. You can see that the shortcuts are distributed into several groups. The Documents and Windows group contains shortcuts for different document commands such as Create, Open, Save, Save As Template, Quick Print, and Spelling. There are also shortcuts for window commands such as Input and Output Views, Print Preview, Close and Switch Active Window, and Quit Program. The Document Views group contains shortcuts for Mind Map and Outline Views, Full Screen and Presentation Modes, Page and Slide Navigators, Zoom and Scroll, and Show or Hide Levels. The Selecting Objects group contains shortcuts for selecting objects on the map. The Editing group contains shortcuts for editing maps such as Undo, Redo, Cut, Copy, Delete, Paste, Search and Replace Text, and Duplicate. The Dialogues group contains shortcuts for clip art, symbols, topic types, topic data, and Map Themes dialogs. The Topics group contains shortcuts for commands to add topics, subtopics, Second, main ideas, main topics or callouts, indenting and outdenting topics, moving topics to the next or previous positions, deleting, selecting and selecting next topics, expanding and collapsing topic levels, arranging branches, applying changes to current level, creating and editing hyperlinks and text notes, searching text, and tweeting topics. The editing text of topics group contains shortcuts for starting or finishing text editing, starting a new text line, quitting editing mode, creating topics or subtopics, or not applying changes. The brainstorming group contains shortcuts for holding brainstorming sessions, inserting new ideas, and quitting the session. The operations on objects group contains shortcuts for sending object back or backwards, bringing to front or forwarding, and toggling between proportional and non-symmetrical resizing. The switching between modes group contains shortcuts for activating the select tool, drawing tools such as rectangle, ellipse, line, or spleen, text editing mode, the scroll hand tool, and constrained drawing modes for circles, squares, etc. The text formatting group contains shortcuts for commands such as format text, bold, italic, underline, alignment, increasing and decreasing font size, copying the format of a selection, and applying copied formatting to a selection. The application group contains shortcuts for commands such as call help system, about concept draw mind map, and options or application settings. The office tools group contains shortcuts for creating a project and creating a project page. The presentation mode group contains shortcuts for commands such as go to next and previous slide, darken and lighten, and exit from presentation mode. The slide navigator group contains shortcuts for commands such as insert new slide, go to next or previous slide, remove slide, transfer focus from the current slide to map, move focus to the map, go to the first or last slide, edit slide title, create slide from visible objects or from selected objects or from selected branches, refresh previews, and start presentation from the current slide. The page navigator group contains shortcuts for commands such as add new page, edit page title, remove page to the left or to the right, and go to the next or previous page. So now you have learned valuable keyboard shortcuts and you have also finished the advanced level lessons. Congratulations! Now you can enjoy more creative mind mapping and receive the maximum benefits provided by ConceptDraw Mind Map and Solution Park.